Hello, today I'm sharing a tutorial video for 7 claw clip hairstyles for curly hair that you need now. These looks preserve your curl pattern and show off your texture. Plus, I'll show you the little details to overcome those common curly hair styling dilemmas as well. Hello, this is April with The Curl Story, a channel dedicated to helping you build your curl confidence with styling routines, techniques, and signature hairstyles. And today's video is all about the claw clip that's always on trend and best of all, curl friendly. So here are 7 easy hairstyles to have fun with. This first look is the high clip hairstyle. This shows off not only the design of the clip, but creates a beautiful cascade of curls from the side and back profiles as well. So you just take a triangle section of your hair at the top, and this triangle is really a style trick because it conceals any part lines. So you just create the widest part at your forehead with the tip of the triangle at the crown of your head and then secure that with the claw clip. Of course, you can play with different sizes of these claw clips, colors, and patterns to see which one you like best, but I really love this effect of the cascading curls. It really shows off the curls, keeps hair off your face, and oh yeah, those baby hairs might pop out, as mine always do. They're always short, they never grow. So I just spray some hairspray on my fingertips, and then I can really isolate where I need to lay those hairs down. Next up is the low half up hairstyle. This one is really elegant, very chic, and all I'm doing is just loosely gathering the sides of my hair, bringing it to the back at around my lip line level. But you can adjust it to where the back or the bottom, where your head starts to curve down towards the nape of your neck. That's where I am securing that claw clip for that beautiful look. The third look steps it up a notch with a little bit more volume. I do have a little helper here. You can see on my wrist a coily hairband. And so with this, I'm going to gather half of my hair just at the middle of the back of my head there. So you'll see I'm just trying to make sure all of my different layers of hair are cooperating. And I'm just going to loosely gather those right at the center and the back. And you can fluff out some pieces. And of course, see, I have some face framing layers that are definitely going to pop up anyway. Now, wait there. I just lifted part of my hair up before I put the claw clip in so I can really pump up the volume at the crown of my head, which you know I love from all my hairstyles. The only thing that I would need to do to finish this hairstyle would be fluff up any extra pieces at the crown to really round out that top, and then rake in some hairspray over the top and around those face framing layers to really set everything in place. The next hairstyle is the low ponytail, which is a simple and elegant look. And there are a few ways that you can be successful at putting this together. Now, when I first did this, I just had my hair loosely gathered together. You can see here, I wasn't using anything underneath, but you can give your hair a little twist if you need help sort of gathering that hair before you put on the claw clip. Or you can also use a coily hairband, which I like to do as well. It really just keeps all of those hairs together, and you can fluff out some pieces too before you put on that jaw clip. And that just gives you a little bit more control over the completed look and where you want that hair to be, especially if you have a lot of layers like I do. Next up is the high curly twist, which is the curly hair version of the French twist. So I start at the nape of my neck and twist my hair all the way up until I get to the crown of my head, then secure the claw clip right at the middle of that. And so the ends of my hair are right at the crown of my head with all those curls just popping out at the top. And of course, I like to use some bobby pins just to place some of those curls in a more flattering position, but still allowing them to decorate the look. It's definitely a very simple and elegant look to wear for most any occasion. Next up is the low twist up. So this one, I start as if I'm doing the French twist, but I actually tuck the ends down this time before securing the jaw clip. Now, I couldn't quite fit all of my hair and ends down in this one jaw clip, so once you'll try out these styles, you'll determine if you need to size up or size down on your jaw clip for your hair and these particular hairstyles. But this one just creates a different profile. It's more angled out, so a different look depending on which style you like better. And of course, I always love pulling out some face framing pieces in front of the ears and around the face for a softer look. This next one is a fun one. It's a ponytail with a jaw clip. So instead of starting at the nape of my neck, I started to gather my hair at the middle of the back of my head as if I was doing a ponytail, but I secured that twist with the jaw clip and then just let all of those curls dance all the way around. So I think I would need a few bobby pins at the top, but this was so fun and very comfortable, I must say, because the structure of that jaw clip really helps to balance out how the hair is being held, because a lot of times standard hair bands can really pull on the hair. That's why I really love using coily bands instead. But this jaw clip underneath is a really fun option, and it makes a big poofy ponytail. So if you love to have more volume in your hairstyle, if you need to add that volume, this is a great option to really show them off. And of course, I'll leave all the details in the description below about these claw clips, or jaw clips as they're also called. And I thank you so much for watching. I hope this video was helpful. And if you're interested, this is all the trial and error. Yes, there's lots of trial and error in the making of these videos. And so based on your comments and working with my curly friends, there's always a lot of testing and experimentation going on. I mess up my curls very often in trying out all different kinds of hairstyles, trying to modify straight hairstyles into curly hairstyles, and just trying to see what works and, of course, figuring out what doesn't. I'm on a mission to put together all the curly hair styling tips and tricks and routines and everything that we need to figure out how to master our everyday curly life. And this really started, as you know, as a mission for my daughter's hair, and then learning that I had to be a role model for her in styling my own curls for every single occasion, whether it was going to work. This is the curl story, all about achieving that curl confidence and knowing our hair in its natural form, how to work with it instead of working against it. So I hope you're enjoying this curly adventure with me. I thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.